You have a job where you work all day on a computer. And now, during this global pandemic, you've suddenly been working from home. How can you set up an inexpensive ergonomic solution so you don't injure yourself? Hi, I'm John Reed from qualitycoding.org. Normally, I focus on technical agile skills for iOS developers, but because of my past and these unusual times, I thought I'd share ergonomic tips with you. These tips apply to anyone who works on a computer, so please share this video with your colleagues, friends, and family. In this video, I'm going to show you how to work at a computer. The principles apply whether you sit or stand, but I'm going to focus on sitting and assume you have a laptop. First, what qualifies me to talk about ergonomics? My background is that I was pretty badly injured. It started as an ache that I kept expecting to go away. It didn't. Instead, I had increasing pain and weakness. I had trouble manipulating things with my hands. I was unable to pick up my children. When I went to have it checked out, the doctor restricted my keyboard and mouse use to 2 hours per day. I had to wear these supports during the day. At night, I had to sleep with these hard wrist splints. You don't want this. Your family doesn't want this. Your employer doesn't want this. If you have a persistent ache anywhere, see a doctor who specializes in repetitive strain injuries. So here's what not to do. Don't work like this. Everything about this is wrong, and it is how I used to work, and it is how I ended up severely injured. What's wrong with this? For starters, my wrists are resting on the computer. Your wrist should not rest on anything as you use the keyboard or mouse, not even a soft wrist rest thing, nothing. My elbows are resting on the armrest as I type. Again, the combination of these two things together is killer because there's stuff moving around in here as you move your fingers. And when there's pressure pinching it off, it's like you're grinding gears of a car. It's terrible. To look at the screen, I have to bend my neck like this. So this is killing my back and my shoulders. There's nothing wrong with slouching if you're going to put your head back and think about stuff. This is fine, but don't look at the computer. Don't enter stuff like this. Let me talk a little more about the armrest. If the armrest is too high and actually causes you to rest your elbow as you type, a couple things you can do. One is lower them as far as they will go so that you can still rest on them, lean on them like this when you want to talk or just think about stuff. But don't type like this. If you can't lower them far enough to get them out of the way, remove them. Typically, there's a bolt on the bottom you can get rid of. That's how not to do things. Now let's look at how to do things. When we're dealing with ergonomics, we're trying to reconcile a bunch of conflicting constraints. But this is what we do all the time with work. This is like auto layout for your body. So let's figure out these constraints. And you'll see how they work. I'm going to start from the bottom up with my feet. In this chair right now, my feet are a little bit dangly. They're not quite resting. So it's a little too high, which is pinching off the supply of blood right here. So let me lower just a bit. There we go. That's better. Another thing to think about is that your upper leg and your lower leg, well, your lower leg should be going straight down for the most part. And your upper leg should be at 90 degrees or a little bit greater, not less. We don't want to pinch stuff off. In this chair, the back is way back. And in order to position my back against the backrest, it's too far back. It's starting to touch up against the inside of my knee, which is going to cut off blood. You really want a few fingers, like three fingers of space between the edge of the chair and the inside of your knee, kind of like this. So I guess the first constraint we can deal with is to get some sort of cushion back here to add back support, but and also keep me from pushing way back into the chair and cutting off my knee. So that's the step one. Now, I'm sitting here at a student desk, and I've got the MacBook Pro up here. Oh, look at this. Look at my arms. This is terrible. If you work like this, you probably have been feeling back pain and shoulder pain, maybe all the way down your back, because you're reaching out. This is not good. What we want to do is we want to have our arms, our upper arms, just dangling straight down. In fact, try this right now. Just let them dangle down wherever you are, whether you're sitting or standing. Let them dangle down. Your forearm should be at roughly 90 degrees or a little bit greater. And you can think of this as T-Rex typing. Rawr. So this is sort of the position we want. Well, this is no good, obviously. This won't work. Thankfully, this desk has something to help, a keyboard tray. And this does help a lot. That's much, much better. If I didn't have a keyboard tray, then I'd have to find a way to raise the chair up. We'll get back to that. So here we are. And now I'm ready to type. My elbows they're rubbing a little bit, but they're not resting against the armrest. I'm in T-Rex position, and the screen is down here. And look at what it's doing to my neck. Your neck is supporting this big, heavy object with the precious stuff in there that's able to code and do whatever else you do on your computer. And it's pretty heavy. Working like this will cause you pain. So what's the ideal position for our monitors? The top of the monitor should be at eye level if your head is looking straight ahead, just resting right over your neck. You should be at a roughly eye level and at arm's length. We don't want it too close, because then you'll be straining to focus. You don't want it too far, because then you won't be able to see anything. So arm's length, top of the monitor, at eye level. Well, how do we fix this? Well, here's a cheap solution. This is what I did for years. I used paper, just printer paper. I would buy it and not open it. You can see this says, Daddy's desk, do not open. And I just stack these up to the right height. That's one option. Another option is to use any big hardcover books you can find, like kids' yearbooks. And so take a little experimenting to get it to the right position. That's pretty close. I want to make it a little higher. There, something like that, arm's length. That's pretty good. With this, I can look at the screen with my eyes going forward and slightly down, which is how they like to look at things that are near. And my neck will be saved. Of course, now I can't type. So what do we do? The answer is to get an external keyboard and an external mouse, because then you can position the keyboard down here and mouse and position the monitor up. So this is, if you don't have a chair, that's the first purchase you need to make. If you don't have an external keyboard and mouse or trackpad, those are relatively inexpensive things that you can do to solve this problem. Now, here's my keyboard. If it's flat, that's okay. But mine happens to get all tenty like this. And now you can see my forearms are, the angle is less than 90 degrees. So that's not good. So I need now to balance the constraints by going up a bit more. That's a little better. Now my feet, now I need to raise this up, and my feet aren't able to rest. So I should probably get a foot rest. So that's another thing that you may need, a foot rest. If your feet, if you have to have your chair up so high that your feet are dangling, we don't want that. We want the blood to continue to flow all through your body. Now, no matter how good your setup is, you will still injure yourself if you don't take breaks. Set up some kind of system that reminds you to take a break at least once an hour. I like to use the Pomodoro technique of working for 25 minutes, then taking a 5-minute break. It's good to physically step away from the computer. This lets my eyes rest by changing their focal point. It's also a great technique for mental breakthroughs. There are various tools to help with the Pomodoro technique. My favorite is a Mac app called Tadam by my friend Radek. Finally, let's talk about the keyboard and how it affects your wrists. Ideally, a keyboard is centered with the keys right in front of you. So the home keys, F and J, should be under your index fingers, right in front of your belly, and you should be typing T-Rex style. What often happens is if you have one of these extended keyboards that has the cursor keys and a numpad, number keypad entry, which some folks really need and like, and that's all hanging off to the right side, what we do inevitably is we center the whole thing in front of our bodies, and this does terrible things because now you're typing off-center and you're mousing off-center because the mouse, if you're mousing with your right hand, is past the extended key, so it's way off this way. So what happens is you end up typing this way. Look at my right wrist here and how it's cocked, and mousing this way, and look at that. Going back and forth, working this way and working this way. Ouch. Pain. We want our wrists to be straight. A way to do this with an extended keypad is to center it so that the keyboard part, that is the F and J keys and all the rest of the alphabet, are in front of you. And then mouse with your left hand because that's not as far as a stretch. Do that, it'll solve a lot of wrist problems if you're experiencing those. Finally, one thing about wrists. If you just let them dangle in front of you, put your arms in T-Rex style and let them dangle, look at how my wrists are. Just look at from the fingers. See how they're angled? Now try right now to straighten them out. Okay, first, they're at rest, straighten them out so they're flat and feel that tension. Feel how it's pulling inside of your arm. If you work with that, if you type like this, that will injure you. The way to solve that is to learn to curl your fingers so that your index fingers are straighter and your pinky fingers are curled and they progressively curl so that you can type like this and keep your wrists bent, angled, but type like this. Now, as far as bending like this, you don't want to type like this with them bent. Your wrist should be straight on in front of you. This creates a little bit of an angle, and there are keyboards that solve this. Let me show you what I use. I have a Gold Touch keyboard that's got a switch on the back to go between Mac and PC. Keys, and this has a lever, a locking lever that lets me, when I unlock it, it lets me do two things. One is it splits that way, so you can see how that solves one problem. The other is that it tents. And that solves the other problem. I highly recommend this. Get yourself a keyboard solution. If you need to switch your mousing hand, do it. If you have an extended keyboard, don't center the whole thing. Center the keys in front of you and switch your mousing to the left. All right, keep yourself healthy. Remember that the most important development tool you have is your body. Take care of it.